Questions? Comments? Somebody up there, you can stand up and shout it. I think that won't be a problem, but yeah. Go ahead. Just shout out the question. Comment the script and ask how you got how you got together with the screenwriter.
Well, I'm going to tell Mr. Jensen that you said that he'll be very happy to hear that. We have a long collaboration, Anders Thomas Jensen and myself, and he's a brilliant writer, and we are both obsessing with moral dilemmas, and I think that you know, it's kind of a it's an entity in itself, but it's also a result of a search that we've been on together for a while.
Yeah, Anders wrote Blood Brothers as well.
Yeah, well, I mean, Opehart Brothers, After the Wedding, In a Better World.
It's
also
a collaboration. Yeah. He's also a great filmmaker himself. Next. Right here. If you could stand up, shout it out. Go ahead. How did you prepare for the role?
Ate a lot of oatmeal. this script is very powerful, and it, you know, as the lady up there said, it's all on the page. Of course, you then use, as always, yourself, your own experiences, and I reached out to. Through a friend to a cop who had kind of a similar background as Andres, just to know, to talk to him about how he dealt with, you know, his work and personal life and how you separate those things if you do. But yeah, it's really, you know, you read the script and you get your imagination flowing, and then you talk to the director and you trust her and you trust your fellow actors.
I think it was just the part in the hardware store, but the preparation. There was, right there.
We had a lot of.
What was it like working with small children?
Throughout the shoot, we had to get new babies in because they grew and they keep growing. Divas. They ate all the craft service, like, well, the babies, the craft service again. No, it was, you know what, to be honest, we got very lucky, and one, you know.
I'm gonna answer that. we all thought that Nikolaj was a brilliant actor, and he did all those amazing, strong scenes with the heart and with all his huge talent. But. And all the women on set thought he was also really good looking, which was quite nice. But then we brought all the babies in, and we had a wonderful caretaker who was very good with the babies. And the moment Nikolaj held the babies, they just fell asleep and were totally dead. So, like, all the women on set were like,
I think of these babies here. It's good to laugh after a movie like this, right?
Question was, how did you keep it together, given the quiet, decent desperation in the character?
I mean, this is what I do. I love this work. This is my job. And you know, you kind of hope, you know, to find material like this is very rare for me. And so this was just, like, so exhilarating. And Susanne, the way she works is she will keep digging at a scene until she's happy. But when she is happy, she will just say, good, we got it, let's move on. And you trust her. And it kind of made me just let go of it. So I didn't, I mean, and I'm not that actor who carries it around, you know, I don't know why, but I just don't. But it was, of course, it was exhausting. Some of those scenes, shoot a whole day of that, it's pretty exhausting. But in the evenings, I didn't really do anything.
Okay, there. And then I can maybe do two more, so hopefully it'll be quick. Go ahead.
The story hinges on a very unbelievable kind of an event that the police officer was going to break into someone's home and hope that they're asleep and the baby's available and can switch. If you go with it, then the film just gives so much help in terms of examining the role and people you think could possibly be good.
How did you, obviously it's an extreme moment when Andreas breaks into the house and takes the baby. How did you approach that in terms of making it as plausible as possible? Which is?
Well, it's interesting because it's obviously one of those things, also in editing, where we went back and forth and we were like, is he going to sit longer in the car before he goes in? And but I think in a way the kind of craze and the agony and the kind of notion of having lost the baby and his wife whom he kind of sedated or where she kind of she's asleep and he needs to go back. I think the craze, I mean, we wanted to maintain the craze so it wouldn't be a question of is he rational? I mean, how would he react if they wake up? Because honestly, I think he would have done it, and I don't think he thinks about what they would do if they wake up, or he would, you know, had he started the fight. I mean, I think it's a highly irrational, almost kind of mechanical act he does. Like his body does it, and he's set to do it, but he only realizes what he's done once he's home again.
And the way I thought it was that, because it is so extreme, he's in shock. I mean, the biggest shock you can imagine, he's just lost his son. And then on top of that, his wife tells him that, if this is true, I'm going to kill myself. So it's just, and there's no room for him in this grief. She sucks it all up. And then I think it's, he needs to get this right. He needs to bring this thing that he can't bring back together. He needs to make something you can make whole. Yeah.
In the back.
Sorry, say that again.
Will the film be distributed in Canada?
Will the film be distributed in Canada?
Yes, it will.
In the middle there. The waiver. Yeah.
I agree with the earlier comment. The film is really brilliantly scripted. Did you go through a series of versions of the story, or was it written as we follow the screen?
John agrees with the comment earlier about the script being brilliant. Did you go through a lot of drafts? Was there a lot of changes from the original version to the next, to the final?
In the collaboration with Alistair Jensen, there are always quite a few drafts, and they do have quite significant changes to them. It's not just within the CE, it's not like tweaks, they are proper thorough changes. And we also did readings, and we also did, like, you know, after Nikolaj and the other actors read it, we then implemented their comments into the final draft.
We have to wrap it up, and thank you guys for coming.